What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you a cool trick when it comes to creating ramps, especially for landscaping and creating paving. So the problem that we're going to be solving has to do with creating ramps or basically surfaces or floors that are at an angle. So whenever you have floors in Revit, especially if you're using them as part of landscaping like paving and so on, like roads, well, if you have to connect two surfaces which are at different levels, it can be sometimes difficult to do that with a smooth kind of curved surface. And Revit really doesn't like that. It can do it with a basic rectangle or something like that, but as soon as you start making it a bit more complicated, it's going to break up that surface and it's just going to look terrible and the connection is going to be horrible. So I'm just going to be showing you different approaches that you can use, and I'm just going to be showing you my workaround that I figured out that gives me really smooth and elegant results. Now, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got over 130 hours of content, and I'm making more each month. Now, for example, I have a whole course on site design and coordination in Revit, which might interest you. Also there you can find some of my ready-to-go customized Revit templates. You can find some really high quality Revit families, and we also have a plugin that might interest you. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and as you can see, I have already prepared this kind of example. So you can see here we have we can say this is part of our landscaping. Here we're going to have some landscape on both of these sides, and then we have a paved floor on the bottom, which is flat, and then here on top the elevation, the difference is 1500 millimeters or 1.5 meters, and we want to connect this with a ramp. So I'm just going to be showing you first the wrong approach, which might seem natural, but it gives you horrible results. So let me show you. If I go here to the site plan, and then if I go here either to a floor, or you can use a ramp, but ramp is just a floor with a slope arrow, so I prefer using the floor tool. So anyways, I'm just going to use pick lines and pick out the outline of this. I have made it especially difficult with this little part here. And let's connect all of this like so. And then we're just going to be using trim and extend to corner to fix this up here. And there we go. Now let's switch to slope arrow. And then let's go from here to here. And then we just want to select that slope arrow and give it a height offset. At tail should be 0, and then at head should be 1500 millimeters. Hit apply. Okay, there we go. And then let's switch this to the 300 millimeter generic one and hit finish. So if you create a slope like this, if I go to the 3D view, you can see it kind of looks okay at first, but as soon as you start zooming in, you're going to see that at the edges, it's usually going to look horrible. See how it has like a, it's tilted a little bit and it just looks wrong. Same thing goes on the top. So here it's tilted, and on the other side, yeah, so it just doesn't look right and it's not correct. So you don't want to use this approach. So alternatively, what you could do is you can now go back, you can select this thing. Let's go to edit boundary and let's get rid of the slope arrow. Hit finish. So now you can select it, and then you can say, okay, I'm just going to modify the sub elements. Well, in that case, if you start modifying these things, it's going to start breaking it into multiple surfaces. So you just have to kind of figure out where each point is going to be, and that's going to be really difficult, and it's going to give you horrible results in the end. So if I do something like this and then I hit finish, it's just going to break it apart and it's going to look even worse than it did with that slope arrow. So let me show you the solution. So for the solution, I'm just going to delete this whole floor and I'm going to create a new one. So just the floor, go to the site plan, and now I'm just going to use the pick lines to pick the start and the end. And then I'm going to use the arc tool to connect the sides and just make it wide enough so it covers everything I need. So you can just do it like this. It looks a bit silly, but that's okay. Then when you have this, you go back to the 3D view and you select it and you go to modify sub-elements. Now here what you want to do is you want to select this end line and then you want to bring that up to here. So now it's going to give you perfect connection both here on the bottom and on the top, and it doesn't break anywhere in the middle. Now you might be thinking, well, that's perfectly fine, but we still have these ugly kind of things on the side, which I definitely don't like. Well, those can be trimmed away. So if you go here on the architecture tab, if you find your vertical opening option, you click on that and you select the floor, then you can go to the site plan and just use pick lines and carve out the part that you don't need. So I can just go like this and then I can say, okay, this whole thing I don't want, and hit finish. So it's just going to cut that away. It works sort of as a void, but it only affects that floor that you have selected. Then you would go again to vertical and you would select that same floor again and use pick lines and just connect it like so. We can even use an arc here, I think. Perfect. Hit finish. And there we go. So now we have kind of carved away. Oh, I have done that wrong. So if you want to modify this cut, as I have made a mistake here, you can just come in close to the edge and see how it only highlights the edge. So not the whole floor, but the edge. And if you hover over it, it's going to say floor opening and then opening cut. See there on the cursor. So you just select that and you go to edit boundary and then you can modify that. So if I go back here to the site, let's delete these two lines and use the pick lines and just pick out these two here. And then I can just use trim and extend to corner here and here. Perfect. And now I have a proper cut. Now what you'll see is here on the top, it's perfectly connected. On the bottom, it's also perfectly connected. And in between, it's perfectly smooth. And that's exactly what you want to see. And then of course you can run a section through that just to check if everything looks correct. And I assure you it will. So as you can see, it's a perfectly smooth surface. So that's going to work. Now you can use the slope arrow option only if you have something like a rectangle. So if you have like a rectangular ramp, then you can use it. Or if it's something like, I don't know, like this, it's going to work. You just add a slope arrow, make sure it goes like so. So it goes kind of horizontal, follows this edge, or actually it has to be perpendicular to the start edge and the finish edge. So in that case, you can use a slope arrow if it's something simple as that. So that will work. And now it will be horizontal or flat, both on the top and bottom. Now also, if you have something like a curved ramp, so something like a car ramp curves, that then you can use the just the modify sub elements. So in that case, you would create a ramp that looks like this. So let's go to the floor, go to the site. And then if you have something like an arc like that, and then you can use the pick lines with an offset of like, so for a car ramp, I don't know, like 3000 millimeters, something like this. And then you get rid of that offset and you just cap it, but make sure that you're perpendicular to the beginning and the ending. So if you create something like this, then if you use modify sub elements, so because it's simple and it only has two lines connecting the beginning and the end, it's still going to keep smooth when you modify that. See? So it doesn't give you any breaks in the middle. So that's just a solution for these types of ramps. But if you have something more complicated like this, well, now you know the solution, how to make it and how to make it look good and smooth. And I don't think it's a difficult workflow. It's just a couple of extra steps. So anyways, I hope you have learned something new. If you want to get access to this project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.